Hello everyone, welcome back to Gurudeva Online Classes. In our previous class, we solved questions from the exercise 2.3 and that exercise was based on similarity criterions. So we have three similarity criterions. Those are angle, angle, angle similarity criterion, side, side, side similarity criterion and side, angle, side similarity criterion. So this is what we learned in our previous class. Today we are going to learn one more new concept, that is we are going to find out the area of the similar triangles. Okay, see, if we have only one triangle here, say ABC, to find out the area of this triangle, we have the formulas, that is half into base into height. And there is one more formula, that is Heron's formula, that is square root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Right? So this is one more formula. We have to find out the area of triangle. But here, if we have two similar triangles, then how can we find out the area of the similar triangles? Right? And is there any connection between the area and the ratio of the corresponding sides? Let us see. Okay, to understand about the area of similarity triangles, here we are going to prove a theorem that will give us a clear picture about the area of the similar triangles. Okay, let us start. Theorem, here is the statement for area of similar triangles. Statement, the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. See, what we can understand from this statement? The statement says that the ratio of the areas, that is, see, here we have two triangles ABC and PQR. Let us consider these two triangles are similar to each other. So when I say they are similar, then you should have the picture of the corresponding sides. The ratio of the corresponding sides is equal and their corresponding sides are equal. Right? So now, here they said ratio of the areas. Ratio of the areas, that means area of ABC. Area of ABC. Ratio is what? Is 2. Next, area of PQR. PQR. Instead of writing this, we are going to write like this, the ratio. Area of ABC divided by area of PQR. This is equal to, triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. Ratio of the corresponding sides, that means what? See here, ABC is similar to PQR. Therefore, AB by PQ is equals to BC by QR is equals to AC by PR. Right? The ratio we have written. What they said here? Square of the ratios of their corresponding sides. So that means what? We have to square this. Okay? So that means what? The ratio of the areas of similar triangles, two similar triangles, is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. That means AB by PQ whole square is equals to BC by QR whole square is equals to AC by PR whole square. So this is the statement. From this statement, we can say that the ratio of the two similar triangles is equal to the square, equal to the square of the ratio of the corresponding sides. Okay, I hope you understand the statement clearly, and we are going to prove this. Okay, so what we do, we are going to prove this. Okay, now let us prove this. Given, what is given here? Two triangles are given, right? Two triangles ABC and PQR, ABC and PQR, and they said they are similar triangles, right? They said they are similar, and triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, right? So the, apart from this, is there anything else given? Okay, so this much only given. Yes, we have written it in given. Next, to prove. To prove. What we have to prove? We have to prove that the ratio of the areas of the similar triangles, area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR, is equal to square of the ratio of their corresponding sides, that is AB by PQ whole square is equals to BC by QR whole square is equals to AC by PR whole square. This is what we have to do. Next, what? To prove this, here we need a construction. So what is that construction? So here we are going to draw perpendicular from A to BC. Okay, we are going to draw perpendicular from A to BC, as well as in this triangle PQR, we are going to draw a perpendicular from P to QR. Okay, so construction. Construction, draw AM perpendicular to BC and PN perpendicular to QR. Okay, see here, AM is perpendicular to BC and PN is perpendicular to QR. Perpendicular, that means what? The angle between the line AM and BC should be equal to 90 degree. That's why we call it as a perpendicular. Okay, so you can observe that. Now we have to prove this. So what is the initial step to prove this? Okay, see, we are going to take the area of triangle ABC and area of triangle PQR, and we are going to divide this area by this area. Okay, so let us do that. Proof. So first, what we do? We are going to take the area of both the triangles. That is, area. That is, area of ABC, triangle ABC, is equals to half into base is what? BC. BC into height is what? AM. Height is AM. So call this as equation number 1. And in a triangle PQR, let us take the area of PQR. Area of PQR is equals to half into base is what? QR. QR into height is what? PN. call it as equation number 2. Divide equation 1 by 2. Divide equation 1 by 2. Then we will get area of ABC divided by area of PQR is equals to half into BC into AM divided by half into QR into PM. Right? So now what? This half and half get cancels. We left with area of ABC divided by area of PQR is equals to, what is remaining? BC into AM is remaining divided by QR into PM is remaining. Call it as equation number 3. See, in the proof, to prove, we have area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle PQR. So now, in the equation 3, we got that. But here, we need to get square on the ratio of the corresponding sides, right? So, we have to achieve that. To do that, what we have to do? So, now we are going to prove this triangle and this triangle similar. So, after proving those similar, we are going to take the ratio of the sides. Okay? Now, in triangle ABM and triangle PQN. Okay? See, angle B is equals to angle Q. Right? Why? Because triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Okay. Angle B is equals to angle Q. Angle AMB. Angle AMB is equals to angle PMQ. PMQ is equals to 90 degree by construction. So now, can we say these two triangles are similar? By which similarity criteria these two triangles are similar? Yes, by angle-angle similarity criterion. Therefore, triangle ABM is similar to triangle PQN by angle similarity. Okay, next, see here BC by QR we have. Okay, next here AM by PM we have. So, let us take the ratio of AM by PM or AB by PQ. AB by PQ is equals to AM by PM. What is equation number 4? Now, in equation 3 and in equation 4, observe. AM by PM we have, right? Here AM by PM we have. Instead of this AM by PM, can we write AB by PQ? Yes, of course we can write, because AM by PM is equal to AM by PM. Therefore, in the place of AM by PM, we can write AB by PQ. Okay? Now, from equation 3 and 4, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equals to BC by QR into BC by QR into C. Instead of AM by PM, what we are going to write? We are going to write AB by PQ. AB by PQ. Right? From the equation 4. Okay? So what the result we got from equation 4, we substituted in equation 3. So as a result we got this. Okay, next one. It is given that, before we are going to write what is given, observe, BC by Q1 we have and AD by BQ we have. Then how we can get the square on the ratio of the corresponding sides, right? So see here, it is given that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, therefore AB by PQ is equals to BC by QR is equals to AC by PR. Why did I write this? Observe here, BC by QR we have, right? BC by QR. See here, BC by QR. Instead of BC by QR, can we write AB by PQ? Because these two ratios are equal. Okay, so now let us write this. Area of ABC divided by area of PQR is equals to AB by PQ into AB by PQ. So this is equals to AB into AB is AB square divided by PQ into PQ is PQ square. Okay, by applying the laws of indices, that is laws of exponents, we can write this as area of ABC divided by area of PQR is equals to PQ, AB by PQ whole square, right? Similarly, we can prove that area of ABC by area of PQR is equals to AB by PQ whole square is equals to BC by QR whole square, that is equals to AC by PR whole square. This means what? See, as we proved here, area of ABC by area of PQR is equals to AB by PQ whole square. We can also prove that area of ABC by area of PQR is equals to BC by QR whole square. And area of ABC by area of PQR is equals to AC by PR whole square. So we can prove that in the same manner. Okay? By including all those, we can say that area of ABC by area of triangle PQR is equals to AB by PQ whole square is equals to BC by QR whole square is equals to AC by PR whole square. Hence, it is true. Now, let us solve some examples based on the area of similar triangles. Examples. First one. The question is, in the figure, the line segment XY is parallel to side AC of triangle ABC and it divides the triangle into two parts of equal areas. Find the ratio AX by AB. So this is our question. Look at the figure. In the question it is said that ABC is a triangle and the line XY is parallel to AC. Along with that, this line XY divides the triangle ABC into two parts of equal area. That means what? Area of this is equals to area of this. Okay? The line XY, it divides the whole triangle ABC into two parts, this part and this part, and these two parts are, the area of these two parts are equal. Okay, so now what we have to find out here, we have to find out that AX by AB is how much, that's what we have to find out. So first let us write given. Given triangle ABC in which XY is parallel to XY is parallel to AC and area of triangle XBY is equals to area of this quadrilateral, or we can say this is a trapezium, right? Because two, there are two parallel sides. Okay, we let us take it as XYCA, area of XYCA. This is what given here. Next, we have to prove that, or we have to find that to find AX by AB is how much? That's what we have to find. Okay, next solution. Now before we are going to solve this, we need the ratio. That means what we need? The ratio of AX by AB. Okay, so that means what we have to do first? We have to prove that the triangle ABC is similar to triangle XBY. Then only we can find the ratio AX by AB. Okay, now in the triangle ABC and XBY, in triangle ABC and XBY, in these two triangles, angle B is equals to angle B. It is what? Common for both the triangles. Common for both the triangles. And next one, angle B X Y. Angle B X Y is equals to angle B A C. Angle B A C. What is the reason? See, AC is parallel to XY and this BA acts as transversal, and these two angles are equal. Why they are equal, or what type of angles those are? Those are corresponding angles. For parallel lines, the corresponding angles are equal. Okay, so corresponding angles are equal. So therefore, by angle-angle similarity criterion, we can say that triangle ABC is similar to triangle XBY by angle-angle similarity. Okay. Now we can take the ratio. How we can take the ratio? See, area is given. The areas are equal. And we have to prove that AX by AB, or we have to find that AX by AB. So then what we have to do? We have to use the area of similar triangles, that is area of ABC divided by area of XBY. That is equals to area of ABC. So let us take the triangle ABC. In this, let us take this line, AB line. AB. For AB, which is the corresponding line in triangle XBY? That is XB. Right here, XB whole square. Okay. Now from this, area of ABC by area of XBY is equals to AB by XB whole square. Area of ABC, it is the sum of areas of triangle XBY and area of XYCA. Right, let us write it. So area of ABC, so we are going to rewrite that as area of XBY xby plus area of xyca, xyca whole divided by area of xby, area of xby, xby. So this is equals to ab by xb, ab by xb whole square. Okay, now what we know, that the area of this part and the area of this part are equal. Now what I do, instead of this I am going to write area of xby, that is area of xby plus area of xby divided by area of xby is equals to ab by xb whole square. Do you understand this? So instead of this we have written this. Why? Because these two areas, that means this area and this area, are equal. So I can write this instead of this one. Okay, now what we get? Area of xby plus area of xby is what? 2 times of area of xby divided by area of xby is equals to ab by xb whole square. Now this area of xby and area of xby get cancels each other and we got ab by xb whole square is equals to 2. Right? Now what? So transpose this square to right hand side, then we will get root 2. Right? So let us do that. Now transpose xb to right hand side and root 2 to left hand side, then we will get ab by root 2 is equals to xb. Why don't we write this equation for ab? That means ab is equals to xb into root 2. Why don't we write like that? Because see here, we need ax by ab. Okay, so but we have xb here. Okay, here we have xb. So that's why we solved it for xb. Next one. What is ab? Ab is equals to ax plus xb. Transpose this xb to left hand side, then you get ab minus xb is equals to ax. We know xb is ab by root 2. Now let us rewrite this equation. That is ax is equals to ab minus ab by root 2. Now ax is equals to, take the common ab from both the terms, then ab into what we left with, 1 minus 1 by root 2. Transpose ab to left hand side, then we will get ax by ab. This is equals to, we left with 1 minus 1 by root 2. So ax by ab is equals to, take the LCM root 2, then we will get root 2 minus 1. So this is the solution for the first example. I hope you understand today's class. And in our next class, we are going to solve the exercise questions on areas of similar triangles. Okay, thank you. And we will continue the class in the next video.